I'm Patrick Quillin, and you and I are getting healthier together. In another episode, we talked about the periodic table of elements, where we mentioned that there's 118 elements or building blocks on the planet Earth, and this is what the physicists and chemists use to work with. And of those 118 building blocks, 25 of them are required in the human body for nutrition. 60 of them are actually found in the body, but we don't really know that of the 35, are they there for toxins or are they ultra trace minerals we need? Not much known about it. 6 of those elements compose 90% of the human body. Now, what I'm getting at is sometimes missing an element can create this host of illnesses that can be attempted to be treated with drugs and surgery when in fact solving the underlying problem, such as a missing element, can be so simple. And I'm a big fan of simple solutions for complex problems. So, of those 118 elements that are on Earth, and of those 60 that are in the human body, and of the 25 that we actually need in human nutrition in textbooks, let's talk about my friend, seaweed. Seaweed, or sea vegetables, there's brown, red, and green type. I'm just pulling out here a nori wakami. This is one of my favorites. Seaweed has most of those 118 elements present in ultra trace level. And so seaweed is an excellent way of getting nutrition. 50% protein, and while it tastes a little bit salty, it's actually, the salt is from potassium. And so American diets are very deficient in potassium, and seaweed gives you a rich source of potassium. So it's protein, potassium, not high in sodium, and then the trace minerals. And we start talking about one of the richest sources of iodide. Iodide is a very unusual element in the sense that we need it in the body, and yet it's toxic to microorganisms. The old explorers would take their pith helmet and fill the water out of a polluted river, and they would add iodide tablets, and the iodide would kill off the microbes, allowing the person, the explorer, to drink the water. And so iodide is selectively toxic to unhealthy microorganisms, but not toxic to the human body. As a matter of fact, it's essential. So I'm back to my kelp. There are hundreds of different varieties of kelp on Earth. They're like vegetables, many of those. And there are favorites around the world, green, red, and brown. The brown and green are the best researched. And what we find is in seaweed, especially green and brown, is a substance called fucoidin. And this is a very powerful growth regulator. It stimulates the immune system. It's an antioxidant. It's an anti-aging, an anti-inflammatory substance. And if you think about it, in the human body, we've got about 50 trillion cells. What orchestrates them? Growth regulators. Fucoidin is one of those substances. So between the trace minerals, the protein, the potassium, the fucoidin, and other good stuffs, I consider seaweed to be a daily snack. It tastes kind of like a thin green potato chip. I'm Patrick Quillin, and you and I are getting healthier together.